Hello guys, a very good morning to all of you. So myself, Neha Gupta, your mentor for current affairs. I hope that you all are doing very well in your life and preparing hard for the examination. The students who are coming for the first time, guys, I prepared the current affairs for phase 1 of your RBI, SEBI and NABARD examination. Also, this video is going to be useful for your banking examination if you are preparing at the level of PO. So let's begin this video, but again, I would like to say this thing, guys, if you are coming for the first time, then do not forget to subscribe our channel and hit this bell notification so that you get the instant updates about the new sessions that we take on our channel. Also, guys, you can join this Telegram group. Here we provide you with the free quizzes as well as you can resolve your queries. So why wait for a long period of time to resolve your queries when you can resolve them instantly at this Telegram group? So quickly join the group. The link is in description below. So here we are at our first question, which is about the Asian India Hackathon 2021. So how many themes are in Asian India Hackathon 2021? So first of all, this hackathon has been organized by Ministry of Education. And who is the Minister of Education? It is Ramesh Pokhriyal Nishank. So Ministry of Education has organized this hackathon. Now, what is the purpose of this hackathon? That we will be discussing a little later. But let's first find out the themes of this hackathon. So we have five options. Option B is 5, option C is 7, option D is 3, and option E is 4. How many themes were there? The right answer is 2. So broadly, this hackathon is based on 2 themes, and the 2 themes are blue economy and education. So these 2 themes, blue economy and education, address the major issues of ASEAN and India. And in order to have innovative solutions and to collaborate on the various issues that India and ASEAN are facing, this hackathon has been organized. So the basic purpose of this hackathon is just collaboration in the field of science, technology and education so that the ASEAN countries as well as India can come out with innovative solutions to address these societal, economical, ecological problems. So that is the whole purpose of this hackathon. And remember, the theme of this hackathon is, the number of themes is 2, and the themes are blue economy and education. So these are the 2 broad themes of this hackathon in 2021. So guys, we are talking about ASEAN. So this ASEAN is a regional organization. Therefore, it is an important one. Now you will be telling me the 10 countries that are part of this organization, the names of those countries. So this is your task that you have to tell me in the comment section below. Next question is, which is the most resilient country as per the PHDCCI International Economic Resilience Ranking? So first of all, what is this PHDCCI? PHDCCI refers to PhD Chamber of Commerce and Industry, and it is an indigenous body. So this is an Indian organization, PhD Chamber of Commerce and Industry. Now guys, it has recently released this ranking, International Economic Resilience Ranking. In this ranking, a total number of 10 top leading economies were assessed, and the ranking shows how much the country is resilient to the pandemic in the international market. So that's the whole crux of this index, basically to assess the economic resilience of a country in the wake of COVID-19 pandemic in the year 2021. So which economy is going to be the most resilient economy in 2021? The right answer is Germany. So Germany is going to be at number 1. What is India's rank? That I will tell you a little later, because India has really performed well. India is one of the most well performing country in this top 10 leading countries. And what is India's rank? That I will be telling you a little later. But first, I want to tell you the parameters of this ranking. So here, parameters have been given. So just first focus on the parameters only. We have first parameter, real GDP growth rate. Second parameter is merchandise export growth rate. Third is current account balance. Fourth is general government net lending or borrowing as percentage of GDP. Gross debt to GDP ratio. So all these five are the economic, major economic parameters that assesses or that foretells the economic resilience of a country. So these parameters are important. You have to memorize all these five parameters. Now in this picture, you can see the top 10 leading economies that were a part of this this index, this ranking. And it's the Germany, which is at the first rank, and India is at the second rank. So as I told you that India has performed exceptionally well, or we can say India is the second most resilient country in the world in 2021. So India's rank, overall rank, is second. Then we have the parameter wise ranking of each country, and out of these countries, which country do you have to remember? It's India. India's ranking on individual parameters is also important for you guys to remember. So in real GDP growth rate, India is first. Why? Because the data that this index has taken into account is of IMF's World Economic Outlook Update January 2021, in which the IMF has forecasted 11.5% GDP growth rate for India in the year 2021 to 2022. So because of this high growth rate, India is at the number one position in this ranking. Then we have merchandise export growth. Again, India is at the first. Then current account balance as percentage of GDP, India is sixth. General government net lending, borrowing, government is, India is at 8th ranking. Then gross debt to GDP ratio, India is at the 4th rank. So these are the rankings of India on the individual parameters. And here in this smart art, you have been given the top country. India's GDP is 11.5%. Then merchandise export, India is at, again, first position with a growth rate of 14%. Current account balance, the top country is Germany. General government net lending and borrowing, the top country is South Korea. Again, South Korea is topping this indicator, gross debt to GDP ratio. So these are the top countries along with the parameters which are given to you in this smart art. So I hope that in this index is clear to you which country is at the top and what is the purpose of this ranking, how is it ranking or how is it assessing the economic resilience of each and every country, and what is India's rank in individual parameters. So these are some of the facts that you have to memorize from this index. Now guys, it's time for my question from you. And my question is, the president of this organization, tell me in the comment section below. Next question. So this is a really very important appointment. Who has been appointed as the new chief executive officer of National Health Authority? National Health Authority. Do you guys remember why is it important, and with which scheme is this health authority related to? So remember that fact. In the meantime, let me tell you the answer of this question. So we have Ram Mohan Mishra, Ram Sevak Sharma, Rajiv Ranjan Tiwari, Rajinder Singh and Ali Raza Rizvi in the options. And out of these five options, the right answer is option B, Ram Sevak Sharma. I hope guys, you have till now memorized with which country, with which scheme is this National Health Authority related to. It is the implementing agency of Ayushman Bharat scheme. Therefore, this agency is important. It is an autonomous body which has been given the task of implementing Ayushman Bharat Pradhan Mantri Jan Arogya Yojana. And recently, its CEO has been appointed. So, the person is Ram Sevak Sharma. You have to remember this appointment diligently. this book is again an important book, I would say. And if you want to delve into the story of Rana Kapoor, the CEO of Yes Bank, then you can surely give a read to this book, but only after your examination. Do not waste time until your exam is done. Okay. So who is the author of this book? Yes Man, The Untold Story of Rana Kapoor. We have Ashish Srivastav, Shalu Sharma, Pavan C. Lal, Aditi Raut, and Astha Saxena Khatwan in the options. And what is the right answer? It's option C, Pavan C. Lal. Now guys, we are on our next question, which is, what is India's score in the Corruption Perception Index 2020? So we have 40, 86, 91, 24, and 73 in the options. What is the right answer? India's score has been asked from you. So from here, you can yourself understand how important the minor facts related to India are. So therefore, you are required to memorize each and every India-specific data given by major indices. So this is one of the most important indices given by Transparency International. So the organization is Transparency International, Corruption Perception Index. What is India's score? So India's score is 40. And what is India's rank? It is 86. Now guys, this index, let me tell you that this index gives the score in the scale of 0 to 100, where 0 is the most corrupt country, 0 score is for the most corrupt country, and 100 score is for the most clean country. And now guys, you would be eager to know that which country has got 100 score, or is there any country that has got such a good score, 100. So let me tell you that no country has got 100 score. The country that has got the first ranking has a score of 88. Now, which country is it? It's New Zealand and Denmark. So both these countries have got the same score and the same ranking, that is first in this index. So the score is 88, New Zealand, Denmark, ranking is first. Now guys, which country is at the bottom? So the bottom ranking is 179th, and South Sudan and Somalia, these two countries are at the bottom of this index. Now you would be thinking that how many parameters are used in this index to assess the countries. So let me tell you that it is a combination of 13 different surveys that have been undertaken by this Transparency International. So these are different surveys, and no specific indicator or parameter has been given in this index. So that's all for this index. You have been given the organization which releases the index, the top country that has got the first rank, the bottom country, India's rank, and parameters are not there in this index. So that's all for this index. I hope that you can easily remember the facts that I have told you here. Now my question from you is the headquarters of Transparency International, that you have to tell me in the comment section below. Next question is about Dhanlakshmi Bank. So again, an important appointment has come up in this video. Who has been appointed as the Managing Director and CEO of Dhanlakshmi Bank? So we have Sushri Devashri Chaudhary, Madhurani and Pradeep Mishra, J.K. Shivan, Gaurav Deep in the options. What is the right answer? The right answer is option D, J.K. Shivan. Where is the headquarters of this bank? Where is this located, Dhanlakshmi Bank? Tell me in the comment section below. And here guys, this video ends. I hope that you have enjoyed the things, the news that I have told you. And if you need any kind of guidance related to your examination, then do feel free to ask me in the comment section, or you can ask the queries on the Telegram group. So if you have liked the session, then do share it and give a thumbs up to this video. Thank you so much for watching the video.